Not all brain tumors are fast growing, and a brain tumor does not necessarily start in the brain. In this video, I will explain the difference between malignant and benign tumors in the brain, talk about different types of brain tumors, including gliomas and meningiomas, and help you understand what tests a doctor might do to determine a treatment plan for a patient with a malignant brain tumor. Just one important note. Many cancers eventually travel to the brain. These are called brain metastases. While some folks may call these brain tumors, these are secondary brain tumors since they do not come from the brain and they actually originate somewhere else. We will not be discussing secondary brain cancers in this talk today. First, what is brain cancer? When people mention brain cancer, they are usually referring to a type of brain tumor. And it is important to remember that not all tumors are cancer. A tumor is a small ball of tissue that forms when cells grow. There are more than 150 different types of brain tumors. However, brain cancer is a term used when a tumor is classified as cancer because it has uncontrolled growth and expands in the brain. What does a malignant tumor mean? Malignant tumors are what we traditionally think of as cancer. Malignant means to spread. So these are the tumors that grow and spread. Malignancy is another way to say cancer. You will want to also know the word benign. Benign brain tumors are not cancerous and do not spread to other parts of the body. This means that someone could have a benign tumor in their brain and this would not be considered brain cancer. How common is brain cancer? In the US, about 25,000 people get brain or spinal cancer each year. Thousands more have benign tumors, which are not cancer. A person has less than a 1% chance of developing a brain cancer in their lifetime. What are symptoms of brain cancers? Only a doctor can confirm that a person has brain cancers, but there are some symptoms you should know about. These symptoms may be caused by non-cancerous or benign tumors, but a doctor should do the test to find out. Headaches that may be more severe in the morning or awaken the patient at night. Seizures or convulsions. Weakness or paralysis in one part of the body. Loss of balance or dizziness. Loss of appetite, changes in vision, memory, or ability to speak. These are some of the most common symptoms. And if you are worried about yourself or a loved one, you should see a doctor right away. What are primary and secondary brain tumors? Primary brain tumors are those that started in the brain and the tissues around it. Secondary tumors are those that started somewhere else in the body, traveled to the brain. As a reminder, for the purpose of this video, I will focus on primary brain tumors that are malignant. These are brain cancers. What are the most common kinds of primary brain tumors? Primary brain tumors are normally named for the type of brain tissue where they started. The most common are gliomas, meningiomas, pituitary adenomas, vestibular schwannomas, and medulloblastomas. Remember, not all of these tumors are malignant, and the benign tumors are not considered brain cancer. How is a brain tumor diagnosed? Diagnosis of a brain tumor starts with imaging of the brain, which includes MRI, CT, PET scans, and may include a lumbar puncture or spinal tap in order to assess whether the tumor has spread to the fluid surrounding the brain. For many patients, the patient will be referred to a surgeon specializing in brain tumors. That doctor will perform a surgery to remove a small part of tumor in a procedure known as a biopsy. The biopsy tissue will be tested to determine the origin of the mass, whether it is benign or malignant, and the grade and molecular features. When looking at a brain cancer under a microscope, pathologists will often give the tumor a grade. The higher the grade of tumor, grade is from 1 to 4, the more aggressive it is. While there is a wide variety of brain cancers, we will talk briefly about a few to give you a sense of the diversity. What is meningioma? Meningiomas are tumors that develop and grow in the part of the brain known as the meninges. These are primary tumors, but are not considered malignant and therefore are not cancer. This is a very common tumor, More than 30% of brain tumors are meningiomas. Many people suspect they have brain cancer when they hear they have a meningioma. These tumors are benign, but they must be taken seriously because when swelling presses against the brain or other structures in the skull, it causes symptoms similar to those made by a brain cancer. Sometimes these tumors are surgically removed, but at other times they are left in place and monitored for growth. If a meningioma is removed, there is a 90% chance it will not return. What is a glioma? Gliomas are brain tumors that originate in the glial cells, which is another way of saying the cells that make up the brain. There are three types of glial cells in the brain: astrocytes, oligodendrocytes, and ependymal cells. The term glioma refers to tumors that start in these cells. Thus, an astrocyte will produce astrocytomas, an oligodendrocyte will produce oligodendrogliomas, and ependymomas will come from ependymal cells. Tumors that display a mixture of these different cells are called mixed gliomas. Gliomas account for 78% of malignant brain tumors. They are rare, but very serious cancers, with different types of rates of survival. For example, there is a subcategory of astrocytomas known as glioblastomas. These are the most malignant of all brain tumors, with approximately 95% of them being fatal. By contrast, the five-year survival for an oligodendroglioma is 75%. How is brain cancer treated? Treatment options vary from person to person. A doctor will gather information about the tumor based on size, type, grade, and molecular features, and consider other important factors such as information about the patient's age, health, and side effects of different treatments. Doctors should always encourage the patient to participate in choosing the treatment. For a low-grade brain tumor, a doctor may monitor tumor growth or do surgery to remove the tumor without additional treatment. For higher-grade tumors, treatment may begin with surgery, followed by radiation, chemotherapy, and additional drugs. Doctors may also offer information on clinical trials. Finally, many people wonder, is brain cancer genetic? Research tells us that at least 5% of brain cancers may be passed on through your family. There is much more research that is being done currently to learn more about the genetic risk factors for cancers that start in the brain. However, at this time, most brain cancers are still what we call sporadic because we think they may happen by chance. If you are worried about brain cancer, it is recommended that you contact your doctor as soon as possible to share your concerns and your symptoms.